In this video, we'll show you how to create your products in KORONA POS. Creating products just takes a few simple steps. So on the left, where the main navigation menu is, you can go ahead and expand it and then click Inventory, and then you'll select Products. You might see some sample products already exist. Feel free to use, edit, or delete these. So to create a new product, we're going to click New towards the top left, and it'll take you to the product editing screen. As you can see, there are a lot of fields, but only a few of these fields are actually necessary. So starting at the top, the product number is already filled in for you. Each product has its own unique number by default. KORONA POS will automatically find the highest number in the database and will add one for each new product. You're more than welcome to change this number if needed. Next, you'll want to give your product a name. It does not have to be a unique name, but for reporting inventory and ordering purposes, it would be wise not to have duplicate names. Next, you'll want to choose a commodity group. If you have not created your commodity groups yet, go back a step and make sure you see the How to Create Commodity in Category Group video. The next field lets you choose an assortment. The assortment is for categorizing how you will order your products. By default, general assortment is the only choice, so go ahead and select that. Next, choose a sector. The sector controls how your item is taxed, and you have two options, general and tax-free. Again, there are some default sectors, but you can change these later as well. The last step you'll want to do is add a price. So click on Add and select price with a date. It'll default to today's date. Click Add, and then enter a price for the product, and then you'll hit Save. As a final step, make sure you click Save again at the very top of the page. And then after that is done, you now have your basic product configured.